Hello, I'm Mr. Arnold Jerry, retired lecturer in Matalogy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity, Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. The parables of the New Testament are my fingertips, and there are corruptions made by the Messianic Jews because they occupied the church for 300 to 400 years. Marcion tried to sort them up. He excluded acts which are highly corrupted. And in Jesus, we have one Father, our supernatural Father called Elohim, Allah, or Parbrahm, and not Yahweh, the Jewish God, who brought them into this promised land and looked after them. So much more you can know if you are interested in the topic. As soon as he read these Acts, 12, verse 12 to 24, as soon as he realized this, he went to the house of Mary, the mother of John, whose other name was Mark, where many had gathered and were praying. Now, praying is not in our fold, because praying is for the worst-born people, and in their prayer they pray to Yahweh, our Heavenly Father. But our Father is living in this temple. He is living. He is no more alienated. He is with us, Emmanuel. So praying is Jewish corruption into the New Testament. Where they are gathered together, they talk about His word, they ponder over His word, and all that, how Jesus suffered, and how confident He was in preaching gospel. And that is why He told them to stay in the most hostile place, Jerusalem, under the protection of our supernatural Father Elohim, and He will protect you, So they were just pondering over and wishing all the best to Peter. When he knocked at the outer gate, a maid named Rhoda came to answer. On recognizing Peter's voice, she was so overjoyed that instead of opening the door gate, she ran in and announced that Peter was standing at the gate. They said to her, "You are out of your mind." But she insisted that it was so. They said, it is his angel. That means somebody else is coming. Meanwhile, Peter continued knocking, and when they opened the gate, they saw him and were amazed. He motioned to them with his hands to be silent and described for them how Lord Yahweh, the subservient of Elohim, had brought him out of the prison through an angel. Angels belong to Lord Yahweh. Angels are messengers. Angels are those who are perfect in the moral laws, and they are subject to sin, not saint. Saints are above angels. So, for the Lord Yahweh, subservient Elohim, had brought him out of the prison through an angel, and he added, "Tell this to James and to the believers." Then he left and went to another place. When morning came, there was no small commotion among the soldiers over what had become of Peter. When Herod had searched for him and could not find him, he examined the guards and order them to be put to death. You know, the worst one people, they are very proud of their ego. So this Herod said, under my rule, and how can they, somebody can go, disappear? So he was very cruel. And he ordered that these guards should be murdered. Then Jewish people were also instigating, hey, look, you big man, how can Peter go free? There must be collusion between soldiers and the people. And so that's instigated by the Jewish people. The Herod ego could not be bound, so he got them killed to satisfy his ego and also to please the Jewish people. Then he went down from Judea to Caesarea and stayed there. Now Herod was angry with the people of Tyre and Sidon. So they came to him in a body, and after winning over Blastus, the king's chamberlain, they asked for a reconciliation when their country depended on king's country for food. You know, this man, ego, you can't talk to him straight. So you have to go through his man, somebody who, chamberlain and other, to whom Herod could trust, you know, or could talk to. So these kings, you know, they are very rude. Ego person dominated by ego is very rude. You can also see. And if a person is sensible, he will listen to you. But man of ego has no patience. He, about that man, is that his own wisdom and somebody's wealth is greater. On an appointed day, Herod put on his royal robes, took his seat on the platform, and delivered a public address to them. The people kept shouting the voice of a god to boost up his ego, you know, to praise him, you know. That is what a stupid man needs. A man full of ego, he needs his ego to be boosted by the people. He seeks the praises of people, however empty they may be. The voice of a god and not of a mortal. And immediately, because he had not given the glory to God, an angel of the Lord Yahweh struck him down, and he was eaten by worms and died. That he became sick, you know. But the word of God continued to advance and gain adherents. That means people who believe in Jesus, they are predestined. Only the sensible people can understand gospel, and only those can join hands with each other to preach gospel. Gospel is preached like a sower. Gospel is not letters. Letters are taught in universities and other places. Everybody can learn letter. But gospel is for those who are predestined, or those who have ears to hear his word. Ear is the spiritual mouth. This one, we eat the flesh of Jesus and take it to our heart and then preach gospel from our own heart, called drinking the blood of Christ. We preach gospel in honor of Christ Jesus to glorify our Father. So, gospel is by grace, and only those people understand gospel who have been predestined of our Father, or who have common sense, and who do not seek the praises of men, but praises of our Father, who, by whose grace they received Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit with small s is common sense. Holy Spirit with capital S is extraordinary sense, which the apostle had at Pentecost. Our Father God blesses you.